Hey guys, it's me Sam, and today's video is a request that has come from one of my long-term subscribers. She wants me to talk about what happens to our skin as we age, how we can take care of it, and how we can alter our makeup to suit it. Now, one of the first things I want to point out is that no one, and I mean no one, stays young forever, even if you do opt for cosmetic surgery. Things are still going to sag whether you like it or not. Now, aging is something that we all have to deal with. Understanding how it affects us can help in preventing us from making mistakes, not only with our skincare, but also with our makeup. As we age, the loss of collagen and elastin causes the skin to become looser and less supple. At the same time, the fat cells beneath the skin begin to disappear. With the loss of this supportive fat, collagen and elastin, plus the pull of gravity, the skin begins to sag and form wrinkles. As you get older, you may also notice that your skin isn't as smooth or tight as it may have been when you were younger. It may also be drier, more fragile and thinner. You may also notice lines on your face as early as in your 30s or 40s, and they basically result from the expressions that you pull with your face. For example, so how can you go about preventing lines and wrinkles? Well, one of the first things you want to start considering is using moisturiser on your face. Oh, and one thing to point out, don't forget to moisturise around the eyes, although you will probably need to use a separate cream for that. I use both types of creams. I like to use a moisturiser on the face, and then I like to use an eye cream on the eyes. In my opinion, the younger you start using these products, the better for you. However, the moisturiser that you used in your 20s may not be rich enough for the 30 or 40 something skin, so you will need to upgrade to something a lot more hydrating. Massaging your skin whilst applying your moisturiser is a great way of moving the lymphatic fluid around and keeping your skin looking plump and bouncy. Now, once your skin hits the age of 40, its natural exfoliation process slows down. This means that dead cells will collect on the surface of your skin and the texture will start to feel uneven. So, another thing you might want to start doing is removing that flaky layer at least once a week with a gentle scrub. I like to use Soap and Glories, and this is the Fab Pore Intensive Action Pore Softening Facial Scrub, and it just, as I said, it removes all your dead skin cells, it opens up your pores, and it just gives your skin a nice fresh appearance. Now, obviously, there are other things that do contribute to our skin aging quicker. This includes sun exposure, smoking, poor diet. The sooner you take action, the better for ourselves. Okay, we're now going to move on to the makeup side of things, as this was something else that Claire asked about. How could she change the makeup that she wears now to suit her once she's a bit more mature? A bit of an office look going on as well. But at the same time, she still wants to keep her famous dark eye makeup. She likes to wear dark eye makeup. I don't blame her, but sometimes it doesn't always go with what you're wearing. I mean, if you're working in an office and you're kind of like got a goth look, it's not going to look right. So We need to try and tone this down a bit, and that's what I'm going to show you now. Obviously, when it comes to makeup, you don't want to settle for basically what worked for you decades ago. You want to open yourself up to new approaches that fit who you are now. Right, to begin your makeup routine, you want to start off by applying a face primer. This one's from Rimmel. It is their Fix and Perfect Pro Primer. And the reason why you want to use a primer is because they blur out the appearance of uneven skin, fine lines, your wrinkles, the work. Oh, and large pores as well. So, as you can see, my skin's completely clean. It's been moisturised. So now I'm going to apply this. I'm just putting a small amount onto the back of my hand. I'm just going to take a foundation, which if you want to use your fingers, you can do. But I'm going to apply mine today using a foundation brush. And I'm just going to sweep this over the one side of my face first. Hopefully you'll be able to see some differences occurring. Now, once you've applied your face primer, you want to leave this for a few minutes before you move on to your foundation. Just basically gives it the opportunity to sink into your skin, which will then help with your foundation when you apply it. Now, as you can see, after applying the primer, my face is looking a lot more brighter, looks more refreshed, and the lines don't seem so prominent as they did before. Now, if your skin appears to look dull, maybe you could try a light reflecting foundation, as they hide flaws and they make your skin look more radiant. I'm going to use Rimmel's Wake Me Up Foundation, as this basically does this job. It has anti-fatigue effect and radiant glow. I'm going to use my Real Techniques pointed foundation brush, and I've already applied some to the back of my hands. And now I'm going to start applying it to my face. I'm going to start off from the centre and then work my way outwards and upwards. Make sure you blend it in. Repeat on the other side. And then basically repeat the same process to the rest of your face. Buff this into my face now using my Real Techniques buffing brush. Make sure it's all nicely blended in. Make sure you bring it down underneath your chin area so you've got no tide marks. Now, one big mistake that some women make when it comes to concealer and their wrinkles or fine lines around their eyes is that they seem to cake it over the top of them. And basically all that's doing really is exaggerating them even more, making them more prominent. Basically, a better approach to concealer when your skin is aging is to use a minimal amount on the inner corners of your eyes only. And you want to choose a product with luminosity, which has the added benefit of lighting up your face and giving it more radiance. I'm going to use this one from Collection. It is the Illuminating Concealer. And you have to click it to activate it. As I said, I'm just going to apply a little small amount to the inner corners. And then I'm going to take my Real Techniques Defining Brush. And I'm just going to pat that in. If you've got lines in your eyes like mine that come downwards, if you just apply that concealer slightly onto the line here and just once again pat the colour in over the top, and that should darken the colour in. Okay, the next step is to set your makeup, and instead of patting unnecessary layers of powder into the skin like this, all you want to do simply is take yourself a nice soft brush like so, and a loose powder such as this one from Rimmel, it's their Match Perfection Silky Loose Face Powder. What you want to do is take some on your brush, top of any excess, and then simply sweep that over your T-zone. So you want to go across your forehead and your nose, like so. And then, just to set the concealer as well, pat some over the top. Right, well, if you're a fan of powder blushes, like me, then unfortunately, guys, it's time to give them up and consider a cream blusher instead. No chance. Sorry, but no. Apparently, powder blushes leave streaks on dry skin and exaggerate the look of fine lines. And a moist formulation makes your skin look naturally lit from within. Now, I've got no problems with this area. No dryness, no wrinkles, no nothing. In fact, this area of my face, I am very, very proud of. So I'm not going to give up powder blushes. But for those of you out there that have got these issues, maybe it's time for you to consider a cream blusher. Now, women with skin my shade, which is quite fair, look best in peaches, pinks, rosy pinks. Those with medium skin tones also suit those kind of colours. Corals, oranges, berries and rich berries and bronzes suit those with darker tones. So once again, you could be used to using a certain colour on your cheek, but it just won't suit you anymore, so opt for something lighter. I'm going to go for a peach shade, and I'm going to use my Stila All Over Glow Face Colour and Luminizer in Peachy Keen. Okay, so I'm just going to take my blusher brush from Allura now, and I'm going to sweep that over my cheekbones. It's a really nice light sheer shade, so it's not really intense. And if you want to build the colour up, then obviously you can. I'm just going to sweep that slightly up towards my temples as well, just to help define my face. Now, as we age, unfortunately, our hair likes to do nasty stuff like thinning. And this does not just include on your head, it also includes on your eyebrows. And the best way to give your face a youthful lift is to have your brows well shaped and well defined. So that's what I'm going to do now. I'm going to fill in my eyebrows. You want to fill them in with quick, short strokes like this, using a pencil or shadow, which is what I'm using. So if you want to do the same, take yourself an angled brush like so. I'm using this black eyeshadow here. Now, when it comes to the colour of what you're going to use on your brows, you want to pick something which is slightly lighter than your hair colour. Now, mine's quite black at the minute, so actually, you know, roots are coming through, unfortunately. So I've gone for a soft black. When my hair's really black, I go for a more intense one. So once your brow is filled in, what you want to do next is take yourself an eyebrow brush, and then you want to brush through them to soften the look. As you can see, it just brings up your eye area and perks them up. Now the brows are done, we can now move on to the eye makeup. And one of the first things I will advise anyone to use before they apply their eyeshadow is to prime their eyes. I'm going to use Avon's eye primer here. There are plenty of different eye primers out there. I like to use Too Faced Shadow Insurance as well. We're just going to apply that using our fingertips. I'm just going to blend this in over the old eye area, bringing it up to underneath the brow bone. Now this will prevent creasing, it will make your colour pop, and it will keep your eye makeup in place all day. Okay, eyeshadow. As we age, we want to avoid bright colours. Instead, we want to opt for soft colours, such as soft greys or bronzes to make your eyes sparkle. Neutral and pastels also complement ageing skin well too. I'm going to go for some soft greys on my eyes today because, as I said, my friend Claire likes to wear dark colours on her eyes. But I just want to show her a different way of having a dark eye look, but without it being too in your face. So I'm going to take my Avon Little Red Dress eyeshadow quad in Starlet. What we're going to do is take this light grey here, and I'm going to apply that to the eyelids, and then I'm going to take this slightly darker grey here, and I'm going to blend that into the crease line. Brush up my shoulders, but not 'cause it's colder. Will it get better now that we're older?
Remember the feeling, a deeper emotion. To be high as a mountain, as deep as the ocean.
To finish off the eyes shadow next, I'm just going to highlight my brow bone, and I'm using this highlight, which is part of my Stila set I showed you earlier, and I'm just going to apply that underneath my brow bone. Blend it into the grey, just to soften it up a bit if you wish. Our eyes are basically a major part of our appearance, but after the age of 40, our eyes, as I've mentioned before, do start to droop at the outer corners. To help give our eyes a little more of a lift, you're going to line your upper lash line with a black liner pen and slightly wing it out. I'm going to use my Ico Skinny Liquid Eyeliner. Love this liner. Always get the perfect line with this. And what I like to do is start in the center here, and I start bringing the line outwards until I want to flip. And then bring that flick back in. Then I move to the inner corner and start realigning the line together. Without you. Just another thing to break through. And then finally I bring the line down towards the area, just to help give my eyes a bit more of a cat eye look. Slow line sweeps. Keep flicking it out until you're happy with the look. Now, something else about the eyes is that not only do our eyelids droop and stuff, believe it or not, our eyes get smaller as well. I love wearing black eyeliner on my waterline. I also like to wear it on my lower lash line as well. One of the things I've started to notice recently is that they do actually make my eyes look smaller than what they are. So, instead of using a black liner for your waterline, maybe, like myself, you might want to opt for either a white or a nude liner. And I'm going to use this from Maybelline. Maybelline, it's a big eyes liner, and you've got a black end and a nude end. And I'm going to line the waterline now with this. Now, if it's not as intense as a white liner, it still brightens up your eyes and gives them the illusion of being bigger than what they are. You can also slightly wing it out along your black liner as well, just to give an extra lift to the outer area. Now, as I've already said, you want to forget about lining your lower lash line with a black liner, as not only do they make it small, they make your eyes look bottom heavy. So instead, you want to opt for a softer colour such as grey or brown. I'm going to go for the grey, and it's part of an eye duo from Avon. It's called In a Blink, like an eyeshadow this size. On the side, you've got a nice soft grey liner, and I'm just going to line this along the lower lashes like so, and then I'm just going to smudge it in just to lighten the look. Now, a great way to bring attention to your eyes is to frame them with lush lashes and not fake ones. But like your eyeliner, mascara in a black shade can also make your eyes look smaller than what they are. So instead, try light coloured mascaras such as browns or greys. I'm going to use this one from Avon. It's a Super Shot Max mascara in the shade Brownie Black. And a coat or two is more than fine, as nothing, and I mean nothing, kills a look faster than clumpy mascara. So I'm going to start off with my lower lashes. I'm just going to apply a coat, because that's basically all you really need on your lower lashes. And then move on up to the upper lashes. Grab and pull them with your brush. try and concentrate on the outer lashes to exaggerate that open-eyed look. Okay, we're coming towards the end of the video, and there's only one more thing really to finish off on one's face, and that's the lips. Now, unfortunately, we lose our lips as well. They start to thin. My bottom lip so far seems okay, but my top lip is basically gone, guys. It's just nowhere near as full as it used to be when I was younger. Now, making your lips look full, again, will enhance your overall appearance, apparently. Wearing lip colours like peaches and beiges certainly help your lips appear fuller and more distinct. Lining your lips beforehand also not only will keep your lipstick in place, but it will also help in reshaping your lips. And it's always a good idea to use a lip liner that matches the lipstick that you plan to wear. Now, luckily for me, I'm not going to be wearing anything too bright on my lips because I want to keep the emphasis on the eyes. So I'm just going to go for a nude lipstick, so I don't need to line my lips. This is from Avon. It is called Noble Nude. It's part of the Ruby Rich range, which I don't think they do anymore. But I love these lipsticks. They have like moisture to your lips. And they've got a bit of a sparkle in them as well. So I'm just going to apply this straight from the body. And already my lips are looking more fuller. I have noticed myself that when I wear bright red lipsticks or bright pinks in my tutorials, my lips just don't seem to be so full. So I definitely agree, my lips do look better in more lighter shades. But there we have it. This is the finished result, and as you can probably see from how I looked at the beginning of this video, that's a bit of a transformation. And it's just a simple makeup look that anyone and everyone can do themselves, even you, Claire. It's very sophisticated, it's very classy, and it definitely suits a much more mature face. I mean, obviously younger people can wear this look as well. Anyway, I do hope I've helped you today, and if there's any questions you'd like to ask me, or if there's anything you would like me to do for you, please do ask. You can either send me a message, or you can leave me a comment down below. I'm not fussed. Just get in touch. And that is it from me. So thank you very much for taking the time to sit the boobies down. And I'm now going to go. Please take care of yourselves. And I'll see you all next week with more crazy costume looks. More League of Legend looks. And more of me. So until then, you take care. And I'm gone.